So you need to see a doctor in Japan. What if you explain your symptoms incorrectly? What if you offend the doctor in some way? What if it costs too much? We'll begin with an outline of Japan's medical system. There are mainly two types of medical institutions in Japan. Clinics, which belong to a single doctor, a mini hospital, if you will. This is where you go first. But usually, you cannot stay overnight if this is what you need to do. Then, you have general hospitals, which offer complex treatments and diagnostics. However, if you go there without a recommendation letter from the clinic, you'll be charged an extra fee. You don't get a doctor assigned to your case permanently in a hospital. There isn't a universal medical record database for all Japanese medical institutions, so you have to register separately. That means providing your medical history to every single specialist you see for the first time, unless you are recommended by another doctor. Now, on to the things that you need to prepare. Insurance card. For short-term visitors, this means private insurance, which will cover your treatment fees if your situation fits their conditions and you receive not only the receipt, but also the detailed description of the procedures performed by the doctor. ID. For short-term visitors, that's your passport. Cash. Debit cards may be a rarity. A list of Japanese words or terms describing important items on your medical history. Use any dictionary you're comfortable with to build up your list. Feel free to use the International Classification of Diseases website to look up your condition's ID and use it as a reference. Next, pick your clinic. For colds and basically when you're not feeling well, you'll go to a NICA clinic. If you need surgical expertise, a Geka clinic is your choice. For sprains and such, go to a Seike Geka clinic. Ambulance rides are free, including any medical assistance provided inside an ambulance, but all hospital-related examinations are not. Next, we locate the institution you're about to visit on Google Maps. We'll provide you with a list of websites in the description. Open hours and days of operation may vary greatly depending on the clinic, so be sure to double-check that the time of your visit fits the clinic's working hours. Keep in mind that you usually can't make an appointment or book a specific time. Once you've reached the destination, you cross the clinic's threshold. This is how it usually goes down. You open the slide door, take off your shoes, put on the slippers. Shoe covers are not popular in Japan. Be sure to put on your socks for personal hygiene. You come by the register and say,
今回初めてです。ちょっと熱があります。
You don't need to go into detail about your condition. A single word description should suffice. The clinic personnel will guide you through the registration procedure. You'll be handed a questionnaire to fill out. We've prepared an example of such a questionnaire, both filled out and empty, in Japanese and English. Be sure to fill it out to the best of your ability. This is where your medical record comes into play. Once the registration is finished, you'll receive your registration card for this particular clinic. So yes, you might end up having a bunch of cards for all sorts of clinics. You'll have a seat and wait till your name is called. Depending on the doctor or time of visit, you may need to wait for a while. You can confirm ETA at the register by saying,
あとどのくらい待ったらいいですか?
And spend your time elsewhere. Be sure to come back 5 to 10 minutes earlier just in case. Don't worry. If your waiting time exceeds the clinic's working hours, the doctor will see you anyway. Once your name is called, you'll be guided by the nursing staff. If you want to get extra points for politeness, you can say as you enter,
失礼します.
And bow slightly. You can also call the doctor
先生.
That saves you the trouble of memorizing the doctor's name. The doctor's diagnosis will greatly depend on how precise your description of the symptoms is, so you need to be concise yet descriptive. This is where your medical record notes might help, just in case something was left out in the questionnaire. You might feel nervous, but that goes both ways here. So don't let it get you down. Don't be afraid to say, I don't understand, or
すいません、ちょっとわかりません。
If things get too hard to process, you'll go back to the reception hall and wait till your name is called by the receptionist. You receive your prescriptions. We will go into detail about medicine in Japan in our third video, which you may later bring to a pharmacy and pay for the examination. The cost of medical treatment in Japan may vary greatly depending on the type of doctor you're seeing, the clinic you're visiting, and your age. For NICA clinic, it's usually something around 1,500 to 3,000 yen for your first visit and a little bit less for all consecutive visits. This cost does not include prescriptions. Lastly, if you need an opinion on the side, feel free to visit another doctor who operates in the same field. And that's pretty much it. Now you're ready for your first medical examination.